Lock your computer when you're away. Hi, everyone. I'm Leo Notenboom for askleo.com. You know, you can have all the best security software that's possible to have. You could be the greatest at identifying phishing and other malicious forms of attack that might trick you into downloading malware. You have the greatest, strongest passwords and doubly secure it all with two-factor authentication. And it's all for naught if someone can latch onto your computer and walk away with it or just use it. One of the things that I have stated repeatedly here is that if it's not physically secure, it's not secure. And it's something that's very, very easy to overlook, especially since we focus so much on all of the software forms of security. Now, like I said, passwords and phishing and this, that, and the other thing. But the fact is, if someone were to walk into my home right now and walk up to the computer that I'm using right now, they could probably use it too. And that implies that everything that's on it is immediately and completely accessible to anybody who might want to access my machine. That doesn't scare me because I have other protections, but it's also something that I've thought about. It's something that a lot of people don't think about. And there are a number of random ways that this kind of physical security manifests that are very, very easy to overlook. Years ago, when I was at Microsoft, I walked past my then manager's office and happened to look on his screen and see that there was a spreadsheet on the screen. The manager was nowhere to be found. I noticed that it was, in fact, our performance evaluation time, and he was looking at like a spreadsheet of our salaries. And anybody walking by could just walk in and see it all. We didn't have smartphones at the time, but today it's one of those things where I could easily see somebody whipping out their phone, taking a picture of the screen and walking away with my manager and the rest of us being none the wiser. I did mention it to him because it was that important. And what we decided the right solution was that either of two things need to happen. In fact, both things need to happen. One is that, if he remembers, when walking away with something sensitive on the screen, lock the machine. The Windows key plus L and your machine is locked. You'll need a password at that point to get back in, but more importantly, whatever was on the screen isn't on the screen anymore. The other is to basically use a screensaver to do the same thing. The screensaver will kick in after a certain amount of inactivity, and I would recommend that it be low in a case like this. And then when it kicks in, then you'll have to supply a password. Make sure that the checkbox to require a password when coming back from the screensaver is checked so that it's not enough to just wiggle the mouse. Somebody, presumably only you, will have to actually enter the correct password in order to regain access to the machine. Now, I have to point out that it's about more than just looking at what's on the screen, right? If you walk away for the day and your machine does not lock itself, then anybody can walk in, sit down, and access whatever's on your machine. They can interact with the world as if they were you. They could fire up your email. They could send email messages, instant messages, whatever. Point being that the ability to physically access your machine is an often overlooked security risk that you probably need to think about and understand whether it's something that applies to you. It might not, don't get me wrong. It is very possible that you'll be in a situation like I am where you feel that that is not a threat. But if you're in a situation where it might be an issue, then it's something you'll want to take steps to avoid. Other forms of physical security. Inspection. especially with travel starting to resume right now, depending on the country that you're entering, you may be required to provide your device for inspection, and that might include its contents. Understanding the legal requirements of wherever you're headed to, I think, is very important because, again, in some cases, including, I think, entry in the United States, it could be required. It could require full access to everything that's on the machine. But the bottom line is that it depends heavily on the country that you are traveling to and their requirements. There are ways to work around it. People who are dealing with this situation in a very sensitive manner typically don't take technology with them, or they'll take cleaned, wiped technology and rely on access to the internet and the cloud to actually get the information and the files that they might care about. But the bottom line is that the device they might have to hand over to a customs agent is not something that would contain anything sensitive. Again, this is something that you'll want to think about if you're traveling internationally. Thieves. Your machines can get stolen. Happens a lot, actually, for laptops, especially when they're like left behind at airports and such. Now, a lot of people are very concerned about that, and I don't mean that that's necessarily a bad thing, but I do think a lot of that concern is overblown, at least from a security and privacy point of view. It's my belief that most thieves aren't interested in what's on the machine. What they're interested in is the machine itself, the hardware. They want to turn around and sell it for a quick buck. So that means that most thefts don't necessarily involve data compromise. However, most is not all. Some thieves are tech savvy. Some thieves will sell what they've acquired to someone who is tech savvy, who can then start mining the hard disk, mining your machine for whatever information you might have left unsecured. So theft is something that I think you do want to pay attention to, but not necessarily solely for the sake of not having lost your machine. It's for having your data be accessed by someone that you didn't want to have access. So what do we do? How do we protect ourselves? Well, encryption is the answer for most of this. I'm a huge fan of whole disk encryption. I really am. Even the machine that I'm using right now, the hard disks themselves are encrypted, even though it should technically never leave my house. My laptop, absolutely. BitLocker whole disk encryption. You don't need BitLocker. You can use VeraCrypt or some other whole disk encryption utilities. But the bottom line is that with whole disk encryption, you don't have to worry about whether or not something is encrypted, whether or not something is protected. Everything on the hard drive is protected. If you're not logged in, then you can't access what's on the hard drive, which is exactly what you want for a thief in particular, but for some of the other scenarios as well. They can turn on the machine, but they'll be faced almost immediately with a password that they don't know, and even removing the hard drive and installing it on a different machine to be able to access the contents will show them only so much encrypted noise rather than your precious data. Remember, though, that if you can't log into your machine, then you can't access that data either. So that makes making sure your account security is set up properly, be it passwords, be it two-factor authentication, be it recovery codes, be it whatever, that you'll never actually lose access to the information yourself because you've protected it so tightly. Something else to consider? Log out. Log out when you're done. Locking is good, don't get me wrong, but logging out is better because logging out will actually shut down all the software, make sure you've got everything written to disk. If somebody pulls the plug or whatever, then chances are there'll be less damage or less potential for damage should that actually happen. But yes, I get it. Logging into your machine is an inconvenience. And in fact, there are articles about how to automatically log into your machine when you turn it on. That's great for you. It's also great for whoever stole your machine because all they need to do is turn it on and they've got access to everything on it. So think twice about disabling logging in. Think twice about whether or not it really is that inconvenient. And like I said, Windows key plus L locks the machine, especially if you're just going to walk away for a moment. This one's a little weird, but bear with me. Take your laptop with you when you pee. I say that because I was in a Starbucks at one point, and doing my stuff in my corner and drinking my coffee. And there was, as usual, somebody else there with their laptop doing whatever they were doing. He got up. He went to the bathroom and left his machine sitting on the counter. Obviously, easily stolen. Anybody could have walked up to that machine, thrown it into a backpack, and walked out of the store. Needless to say, that didn't happen. And being who I am, I probably would have said something, or I would have at least noticed what had happened. But the bottom line here is that he left his machine unattended, unlocked and unattended in a public place. Don't do that. If I'm at Starbucks and I have to use the restroom, yeah, I'm going to put my laptop in sleep or whatever, take it with me, and not lose sight of the machine. It is that important because it is that easy to lose something that way. Finally, lock the doors. If you're in a situation, your living situation or a work situation or some other situation where you actually cannot trust the people around you or the people who have access to the same space, be they coworkers, family, strangers, whatever, then it's on you to physically lock or physically protect your machine. Locking the doors to wherever the machine is kept is one way to do so. Another is to tie it down. Most laptops have a slot for what's called a Kensington lock. It's basically a cable lock. It's much like a bike lock, except it's designed specifically for laptops and other portable devices. Chain it to your desk. Chain it to something immovable. That's one way of making sure that your equipment, your computer, your laptop isn't going to walk away. And of course, if you're going to travel, think about it. Make some plans. I don't know if that means that you need to take only pristine equipment with you, that you need to take only things that can access the cloud with you. I don't know if that means you actually buy a temporary machine in a new location. Whatever. Think about it. Think about it from two sides. One, what happens if you lose the machine while you're traveling? Make sure you've got a recovery plan for that. But more importantly, if you do lose the machine or the machine gets stolen, then make sure you are using things in a way that the thief will not have access to your data. And that is probably whole disk encryption, among some of the other things that I've talked about so far. So I hope that gives you some things to think about. I've thrown out a few answers. There are probably more techniques and more tools that you may want to consider, but please don't forget about physical security, be it in your home, in your workplace, or as you travel. For links, for updates, for comments, and more, visit askleo.com/26678. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.